in kiteboarding, you know, kiteboarding, we like in a really kind of messed up world, you know.
The fun when it first started came from just being able to do things that were like really simple. Like I did a jump and I landed. I was like super stoked, you know. And as I went along and I started getting better, it started taking like a bigger move to make me happy.
I think you wake up and you don't even know if it's gonna be a good day. The conditions are bad, and then you get kind of pissed, and then you don't land anything.
We deal with stuff that no other sport deals with.
You'll be hitting something for like an hour or so, and it's all lined up, and you're starting to feel good and starting to flow through, and then you get a little wind shift, and all of a sudden you can't even start to make it halfway across something that you were just nailing, you know, 2 minutes beforehand.
It's kind of like a chaos that you gotta go around to land one trick.
5 second clip could come out of a whole day's work. You could actually go months at a time without getting what you really want.
Sliders, you can go for a while where you get hits, you get good hits, and you never fall, you never get worked. And then one day you get freaking worked. That's all it takes, one mess up.
You gotta see the slider as the track, and you the train. The train must ride the track. So be the train.
If you take a really bad wipeout on a rail, it's worse than any wipeout on flat water.
Consensus.
Get drugged up for a week and get better. That's about it.
When are you gonna ride again?
Tomorrow.
What else we need?
Screws, screws, and one.
Oh, bolts. Oh.
The reason we decided to come to Antigua, it was mainly because, one, you know, the wind here is really good. When it's on, it's on. And Andre, being a local boy, had access to, you know, a lot of hookups, you know, basically the house. He knew all the hardware store. We basically knew what to build. We had contacts. But I think the most important part is that we had a place that had been private, that is not open to the public. And we basically wanted to like create our own Kai Beach over here, but like focusing sliders.
It's good.
That looks pretty good, yeah?
Why don't we just start all over?
So if we draw a line right now, we shouldn't go wrong.
We decided to do something that is really never done before in kiteboarding, you know. There was the sea rail.
The sea rail is definitely the biggest pain in the ass to build.
So we gotta need braces to make sure that the bottom leg...
But once you put the leg where it is, it's not gonna move.
Yeah, it will.
We argued forever on how we were actually gonna put it together.
It's not gonna just spring over.
The thing had probably the most time put into it as far as construction goes.
The problem is we drew half a curve. That was the problem. Yeah?
God damn it, they cannot make the f***ing line, dude.
You want me to show you how it's done? Let the pro work.
Pretty cool because, you know, it's something never done before and it was really hard to build. You know, it turned out really good and we had a lot of fun. It was worth it.
The sea rail. I think took me out a couple of times. I was trying to do like a 270 on and caught my nose at the beginning and then like flipped over and hit my head on the pipes or something, I don't even know. And then I came up like just saw stars and shit.
I like session in a kicker because you don't have to be as precise to get on it. We'll be right back.
say the obstacle we built that was the most fun was the kicker, just because we get into a session on and it didn't get as crowded as the other two rails, and people just roll through tricks. So, you know, everybody kind of gets warmed up, and then one guy steps it up, and it just pushes the next, and then, you know, you see people having good days and bad days, and when somebody's on, they're on, and you know, stuff just starts going down.
Hey.
You don't want to put a boat all the way on top?
Put what?
Not a boat all the way on top.
What do you mean?
Like.
Perfect. Then we built the A-frame and we decided that we were going to put like a kink in the upslope. And that was going to be 20 foot long. Then we're going to have a 20 foot flat section and then 20 foot down section. And it, the whole thing was about 10 foot up.
connections, connections. Warm it up, cause y'all need to know one thing about me. I am the terrorist, terrorist, terrorist. I bet it's a lyric, deeply embedded and too much headed. Conviction, confusion, conjured by motion. I sit in both and it's both. And I'm forced out from the field. You see, it's the international slicer. Monster slasher, Paul Lasser. Section wrecking like Tekken. Karate fight, rhyming, rapping. Move out with special protection. My special move, my spinning lash. I rotation the words into a boomerang. Retrieving the thing. Deadly incision, blood sucking vampire bat thing. Show up Bay Area werewolves from London around the UK. Well, the wolf, how will eat shit in your hairway? With an ugly bra, smelling like Nexus, using Humexus, smoking Marlboros, AIDS infectious, weighing less than your gold necklace. She'll share the needle, I know, I'm not addicting and sickening, that's why I keep on inflecting, and return, different human being, each ripping. Terrorist, 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 T-E-R-R-O-I-S, terrorist, 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 terrorist. Bring a bunch of terror. Terror. Bring a bunch of terror.
there, it's so perfect that, because it's not gusty, and if there's wind, there's kickers, you know?
We went with the whole crew to Coche, Venezuela, to hit the slider park there that they built, which was pretty sick.
Very nice A-frame, like a pretty big kicker, a flat bar, kind of relentless slider, and flat water all over.
Bertrand, he hasn't been doing much kite loop, so he's worthless.
Moy is actually, you know, a guy that, you know, just by the effort that you see he's putting into the tricks, actually makes you want to go out there and try hard, you know. So definitely when I see Moy riding, I'm like, fuck yeah, you know.
Dre, Dre, if he wanted, he can make a video of just him. I think a video will be done by now.
You know, like out of the whole crew, you know, I enjoy riding with everyone, but like Dre, you know, he's always motivates a lot when he's riding and he makes everything looks really easy.
You know, overall watching Dre ride, you know, he's got the biggest, smoothest style out there. It almost looks like, you know, something different than you see anybody else doing kiteboarding.
Thank you.
Dre. Scene 3. Take 4.
Action!
So what?
Cut! Jesus Christ!